Hi, thanks for coming to Diane Potter Yoga. If you've been here before, thank you for coming back. Today, I'm going to do a yin yoga practice with the wall, some help from the wall. So if you wanna pause me for a few minutes and clear out some wall space, it'll be worth it. I'll meet you there at the wall. So, I would like if we start on a block in a seated pose with the block against the wall. So block is smallest height, shortest height I should say, and you're sitting right on the block at the wall. Try to get your entire back on the wall. And take five breaths in and out, full, long, slow. In breaths, out breaths. Press the back of the wall into the mat. The back. Press the lower back into the wall. Press the middle back into the wall. Press the upper back into the wall. Lift the crown of the head and tuck the chin just slightly and take another deep, long, slow breath. Now start to peel off the wall. Reach your hips, tuck your hips in, tuck your chin in. Tuck your chin in and roll your back off the mat, off the wall, coming all the way down, all the way down, all the way down, all the way down. And then fold over your legs in any manner, any length, any height you can, just fold over your legs and breathe. Three more breaths. Walk your hands back to the mat, back to the wall. Now you're gonna press your lower back and press it into the mat. Now you're going to ripple through your entire back, vertebra by vertebra, cling to the wall, as if you're pasting one of those things on your phone and you don't want any space, no air space at all, just getting the vertebrae stuck. You can feel it all the way up your back, rippling up your back, opening up every vertebrae and breathe. Now let's switch the crossing of our legs. We're gonna roll down and then detach the head off. Tuck your chin into your chest and let your back roll off vertebra by vertebra the other way. Let it roll down till your head hits the floor. Breathe. Work yourself back up. Hips should hit the wall. The lower back hits the wall. You can walk your hands up all the way up to your legs, all the way up to rolling each vertebra of your spine into the wall. So the whole entire length of your back is on the wall again. Some nice long breaths here, three breaths. Time to release the block, come into a little bit of a squat pose. If you want to sit on the block to begin with, that's okay. I did that for a long time to develop some flexibility and strength in this pose. If you don't need it, you could just let go of it. We'll just be here about 10 breaths. This is moving awfully quick for yin class, so I'm about to slow down and talk a lot less so that you can just hear
your inner promptings and be curious about your inner landscape. If you want to interlace your hands, bring them forward, tuck your chin. You can let your butt fall on the ground. You can take a block under your feet. If this is super tense, you can take this with a block under each knee. That works just fine too. The diamond cobbler pose. You're just going to make your way. And if you like, I always like to massage my the inner arches of my feet along the way. The outer inner edges and the tops between the bones of my feet. I like to do that here. Just and then let's fold over your legs. Say about 2 minutes. I'll be quiet. Slowly release your legs. And about you, but my back needs to be in a back bend after that one. So we will take this with blocks and supported fish pose. So this should go right under your brow line. And if you would like to have a pillow or a yoga block for your head to support, or you don't need that, that's fine. You don't need it. You don't want to use it then. Relax into the block. If at any time this gets a little too intense and you need a break, you can walk your feet under your knees, bending your knees, and just lift your hips to release it. And just go back into it again. Or you do this as many times as you'd like to. Feels great and it's good for you to help you with the opening. If you want to go deeper, you can bring your arms over your head. Release your fingers. even do both. Lift your hands over your head and lift your hips off the mat. Press your heels down. And 10 more slow breaths. Now, if you want to come onto your elbows, press into your elbows, roll your shin up, mark your knees in, come onto your hands, hold on to either elbow, wrapping yourself around your knees, rest your head on your knees, and tuck your chin into your chest, and let yourself roll down to curve your spine. Release this further by doing something at the wall, because we got the wall here and we're going to use it. So what I love this, and actually I would like for you to see me do this, so maybe the wall's not the best option for this ankle, but this ankle's not the best. So you stand at the wall. Me, I'm going to use this stool. Your hands are against the wall and you just rest your chest through your arms pressing into the wall. It's like pressing into the wall. This is something I usually do in my sink. So you're pressing into the wall, reaching hips back, breathing, letting your head fall through your arms. Another 10 more breaths. And release your hands down to that ragdoll position. Hold on to your elbows and let your head relax completely. Maybe shake your head yes, shake your head no. Make sure you're not holding any tension in your neck at all. Breathe. Need to bend your knees, bend them as much as you need to. Just make sure you're not holding any tension in your neck. Let it go. And release, come to a squat again. You can sit on that block if you like to here. I just hold it for a few breaths. And sit down. And use this wall space again for a forward fold at the wall. So let's put our feet up the wall and walk our hands in our butt to touch the wall. Hands behind your back and your butt touch the wall. And just look at your feet. Point to flex. And breathe. 20 breaths here. Release it, come to your elbows, and then back down to your back. And you're going to take a straddle position at the wall using the wall for an assist. Just let your legs open as wide as they want to, letting gravity do the work, and time and gravity will do it all. Just breathe and relax. If this isn't too intense for you, you can bring your feet together and let your knees fall out to the side. Cobbler pose, we'll probably go there anywhere. Anyway, we'll go there from here. So whenever you're ready, if you are ready to do that, go ahead and do that. If you're not, if you're ready to hang out, just breathe and hang out, close your eyes and don't compete or compare. Just be where you are today, your practice, honoring yourself for making it to the mat. If you are ready, you can hold onto your knees and bring your feet together. Let your knees come out to the sides. You can seal this by holding your hands over each other in your belly or crossing your wrists over your head. Keep breathing. If you find yourself distracted, just go back to your breath. You can even say a little mantra, I am breathing in, I am breathing out, I am breathing in, I am breathing out. Holding my wrist with my hands, my feet are touching. This is considered a bound pose, sealing the energy. Another nice mantra for a bound pose is, release me from the bondage of self. You can keep repeating, release me from the bondage of self. My right leg straight up the ceiling, and I'm just going to let it fall out to the right. Letting my lower back, the top of my right hip, along the highest part of my glute, is getting a floor massage because the floor is providing pressure for that area, and it's kind of a nice release for the lower back. Be about for about 20 breaths. If this is too intense for you, you can put a bolster onto your leg or not. depending on what you need. Just breathe. Let your body open gradually. Oh, five more breaths. Take the left leg straight to the ceiling. You can hold underneath the right leg and bring it up to meet the left, nice and slow. You can pause there, waterfall pose. Bring your arms out to your sides. Getting all the benefits of an inversion with none of the work. Just relax, it's really good for swelling. Let your left knee fall out to the side. Bend your right knee. Let your left leg fall out to the side. About 20 breaths here. Nice, slow, long breaths. Hold underneath your left knee and bring it up to the ceiling. Now, bend your left foot, knee, so your foot is pressed against the wall. And your knee, maybe if you need to roll your hips back a little bit, that's okay. You can do that. I'm getting a little bubble in my carpet, so rug. So cross your right ankle over your left foot for a pigeon. If you want to get closer, you can walk your hips closer to the wall. That will help you take your right shin closer to your chest. primal breaths. Let them be conscious and slow. Release both of your feet up the wall. Five breaths. Bend the right knee and keep the right foot parallel with the knee on the wall. Cross your left ankle over your right knee and breathe. Exhale for pigeon. If you want this to be more intense, you will keep your hips closer to the wall. And if you want to back out of the pose, just back your hips up. And surrender wherever you are. 20 breaths, maybe 25. Nice. Bring your feet up the wall. Oh, five breaths here again. Surrender. Now, come to your elbows. Leave your feet where they are. Let's walk yourself up for a forward fold of the wall. Your fingers are pointing behind you to the wall behind you. You're using your arms to bring your forward fold to the wall. Tuck your chin and look at your feet. And somewhere in between, rest. If your legs need to be bent here, that's perfectly fine. Back to your elbows. Set your feet off the wall. Sure. Is your carpet bubbling up like mine? Okay. I'll release that with a squat pose, yogi squat. From side to side, opening up through the hips. Feel how different you feel now in this pose than in the beginning. And release down to your butt. I really love to do a supported bridge. So just slide a block under your sacrum here. And that's the render for about 20 breaths in this side. Take your right knee into your chest with the block underneath you still. It's a very lovely pose to release the sacrum, aid digestion, wind relieving pose. Let's take this now. You can leave it at this height, put it on a lower height or a higher height, depending on what you feel that you need at this point. I'm going to go for the highest height for the last 20 breaths. You have to do you.
Okay, let's release that. Hips up and then roll down. One vertebra at a time, rolling through your spine until your sacrum lands, and then bring your knees the width of your mat, drop your knees together to release your hips in constructive rest pose. Bring your hand to your heart, bring your hand to your lower energy center, maybe your belly button, maybe 2 inches below your belly button. Your knees into your chest, lift your head to your knees, squeeze your lower back to the floor, and then let your entire back stay on the floor as you press your legs into your chest core, and then take your knees over to your right, arms are goalpost or straight depending on the room you have. If you want it deeper, you can straighten the left leg straight at a diagonal. I'm sorry, left arm straight at a diagonal behind you. And breathe. About 25 breaths, yeah. And bring your knees straight to the ceiling. Maybe shift your hips to the right. Drop your knees over. Maybe I need to shift my foot a lot because I don't have a lot of space on that side. But I have more space on this side of my arm. But I'm still going to keep it even. I'm going to take my right arm straight at a diagonal back. I'm going to take my left hand over my hip and give it a little assist over. You can even start with a neck neutral looking at the ceiling. Be here for 25 breaths, so you know you might want to gradually deepen this as you go. I did a yoga class before this, so I'm really, really ready just to take a deep twist here. You have to do you though. To your chest, hug your knees, and put your forehead on there, and roll back. Excellent. Let's roll, rock and roll up the spine. I've kind of completely gone off my mat, so I can have more space with you. It's okay. Hopefully it doesn't matter too much if you're on or off your mat at this point. What we're gonna do is make your weighted mat if you like. Some deep forward folding
many people, and myself included, like to have some support in a widely fourfold. Find the body enjoys the release more. You could remove it if you find that it's holding you back. And if that's the case, you can start with it. And as your body opens, you can gradually let it go. And you're not really going for 100% yin. You're just slowly opening, okay? So take your time. You can get it down. You can come to your elbows and rest on your elbows. You can point, flex your toes. You can lean over to your right. Maybe release your neck both ways. Wait a minute. Release the neck today. Release the neck both ways. You can actually release the neck now. I think you're right. Let's do this a little. Let's bring our feet together for this one. Cross at the ankles. Just crossing at the ankles here. Walk your right hand to the right. Take your left ear to your left shoulder. Maybe bring your left ear back and forward. Maybe you can rest your left hand behind your back. Maybe let your hand fall to the floor behind your back. See where the stretch, where the tension in your neck lives, and breathe into it. Take your right hand on your, right shoulder. Release your left hand over your head. Gently rest your hands. Breathe into the opening of the side of your neck. And release your head to the floor. Release your hands. Feel the energy and the space you created in your neck. Take your right ear to your right shoulder. Walk your left hand out to your left. Take your right hand behind your back. You can let it rest on the mat. Just find where the stretch lives for you in the neck, and maybe just tilt your neck back and forward till you find it. Breathe into it. Little 5 breaths. Take your left hand on your left shoulder, pull it down. Let your right hand rest on top of your head and breathe. Now we will actually do the Uddiyana Konasana. So take our legs wide apart. Varsa is going to join us. Great, Varsa. Get in, lean over to the right. Push your left hip down. Lean over to your right. This is actually my left. Hi, Varsa.
Hi.
Sit down, down. Now, it's okay to come onto your elbows and find out where you need to be. This might be where you want to stay, hang out. You might want to sit on a block to get some assistance here. It's yin, so we're not forcing anything. We're not going to compete or compare. We're just going to, you know, have a bolster, a big pillow underneath us to support us as we release into the pose. As we go and you find you need less and less support, it's okay to get rid of the bolster. If that's what your body needs, it's craving, you have to listen to what your body needs and it's craving. So let's just stop talking for now and take this at your own rate down. You could maybe start resting your forehead, and you can make a pillow with your arms on
on the bolster. Maybe you could rest a cheek. When you're ready, come on up. Move the pillow. Hold on to your inner thigh. Outside of your legs, nice and slow, bring them back. Going to come forward on the mat. So I'm just going to send my knees to the left. And send my knees. Right. Nice way to open up and release from the inner thighs is to take a block under your ankle. If you don't have a block, you can just rest your ankle on top of your leg. Above your knee and let your knee just flop open to the side, and this helps you release the inner thigh, and it's just an outward rotation of the leg stretch. About 20 breaths, yeah. toe, your foot off the block. Bring it to the outside of the mat. Maybe both the knees can come towards each other. Constructive rest. Scoot your block over to the other side. Bring your right knee down. Left ankle can rest on the block if you have one. If not, your the bottom of your thigh above your knee. We'll be here for about 25 breaths. Just breathe nice and slow. Whatever mantra works for you. I do like release me from the bondage of self. So I'm going to grab hold of my left wrist with my right hand. Make a seal, my foot touching my leg. Sealing the energy. Remembering my mantra, release me from the bondage of self. Spirit, release me from the bondage of self. Direct my thinking. Your knee back. You can actually, with your foot, move the block off of your mat. Your left ankle is above your right knee, actually, towards on top of the thigh. Now we're going to take the right thigh and leg out to the right, and your foot will come with it. You can decide if you want to hold your ankle here. You're going to hold on to the back of the thigh or the calf. It is a nice place to seal, to bind. And breathe. You're breathing. We'll go to your left shoulder. Ten breaths. And bring your right knee to the ceiling and left ankle stays on it. Inhale, toe your right foot off of the mat and let your right knee drop to the center, being supported from your left ankle still on the right thigh and feeling a nice oblique stretch, side stretch. Breathe. Before we, let's heal so the right toe in again. Before we release entirely, I do like that stretch where our knees are together. And then we just drop the right knee out to the right. This creates all kinds of space for your lower back. Creating space so the spirit can move through you. About five more breaths. Bring the right knee up to meet the left. We get to do the other side now. So the right leg is going to cross over the left leg, the right, at the right ankle is just above the knee. I'm just gonna come into a T and drop your legs over to the left and your ankle stays attached to your leg. And here's where you can grab your ankle if you like. Or your knee, or your thigh, or your calf, wherever feels best in your body. Just breathe. Let go. Heel toe your left foot in. Maybe you can heel toe, keep heel toeing it towards the outer edge of the mat and bring your knees to the right in that oblique stretch. Oh, 15 breaths. And heel toe your foot back to the center. Bring your knees together facing the ceiling. And we're gonna let the left knee fall out to the left. Your feet can be touching here. And just one more stretch before we call it in Shavasana. This is going to be a bound banana stretch. So I shifted my hips slightly to the left. Now that's not really necessary, but we are going to send the right foot out to the right corner. And we're going to bring the left foot right next to it. Okay. Take the arms out to the other corner. We hold on to your right wrist with your left hand. And if you can keep both of your hips on the floor, you can take your left ankle and cross it over your right ankle. And if you feel you need to move your legs or your arms a little closer, that's okay, you can. This can get to be pretty intense, this stretch, the banana stretch. Stretching out the entire side of our body, and it isn't a bind again. Five more breaths. If you feel that you have not yet achieved the drop-in space of this posture, you want to hang out here, everything I say is just a suggestion. You know your body, and you can pause me at any time and do whatever you need to do, or stay as long as you need to stay. I'm going to move on out of this pose just to come to the center of the mat, just to get grounded and feel myself grounded into the mat. Now I'm going to take, maybe shift slightly, my hips slightly to the right, feet to the left corner, and arms to the opposite left corner. And I'm going to hold onto my wrist, hold onto my left wrist with my right hand. Press my right foot over my ankle. Trying to make sure that both of my hips, my sacrum is grounded into the mat. Oh, five more breaths. And walk your knees back, feet back, into elbows.
this might be where you want to stop, and have a wonderful rest of your day or night. I'm going to do a shavasana with my legs resting on a couch. That's one of my favorites. It's always very beneficial to end if you're so close to the wall and you want to do legs up the wall for shavasana. It's a wonderful shavasana, and it's very, very restorative and lots of benefits for that posture. So I'm going to take my mat close to my couch because I feel that I can use the hip flexor release. So in this pose, I'm gonna just let my hip flexors drop, and I might leave you here, and I'm gonna stay here for as long as I can, as long as my video will let me. If I have the time, my video doesn't run out, I'm gonna stay here because this is very beneficial. Barsa, will you go in? Barsa left.
start to wiggle your toes, wiggle your hands. You want your knees in towards your chest and you roll into a fetal pose. Maybe through each breath to transition or not. You can stay on the couch as long as you got. Mayapaja style. I'm going to come to a seated pose one last time. Thank you so much for joining me in my yin class. May be happy, may be grateful, may be abundant, may be blessed. May you love fully. Have a wonderful day and keep coming back. I got lots to give. Don't forget to like and subscribe, or share and subscribe even better. Thank you. Bye.